I was a quote-unquote IT guy, but I wasn't. Here's how I got hired at NASA, and I'm not making this up. This is how God works. God sets us up, dude. Okay? It says he orders the footsteps, right? Of the righteous, right? And if I'm righteous, because of the Holy Spirit. Not because of me, folks, anybody listening. The internet was new. It wasn't even called the internet, the World Wide Web. There was a number of universities and military sites on the web, and I worked for ChemDemil, Chemical Demilitarization, at Aberdeen Proving Grounds as a civilian, but I did tech support for the engineers destroying VX gas, nerve agent, okay? So the internet was new, and I had put my resume on the then internet. This was a day when, if you got free web space, it was literally 30 kilobytes. Kilobytes. Okay? Of free web space, and that was a big deal. This is how far back it was. Email, there was no such thing as attachments, MIME types. You couldn't attach a photo and just send it, or it was all command line, okay? So this is back in the dark ages in technology world. And I put my resume on the internet. NASA called me. They called me, and it was this lady. She was an IT director, and it just during the conversation, she said she saw my resume on the internet, and I guess they assumed because it was on the internet that I must have known what I was doing because it was pretty new, right? And so anyway, during the conversation, this is how God sets you up, dude. I'm serious. This has happened to me a lot of times because I'm gregarious. I'm friendly. I just say what I think. It's helped me. I hear her, she's chewing gum while she's talking to me, and she all of a sudden kind of goes, "Oh man," I'm like, "Oh what?" She goes, "I'm working on this NT box and this that." I said, "Oh, just do this. Click here and type this command. Click, click, click." It was fixed. Dude, I was hired. I was hired. They took me to lunch and asked me how much money did I need to make. I'm not lying. The whole time my knees were shaking underneath the table. It was a Chinese restaurant. And this guy, Jack Colletti, "Well, Dave, tell us how much you need, how much you're making up there at Proving Grounds." And I lied. I told him I was making $12,000 more than I was actually making, and he gave me an additional $3,000 on top of that, or $5,000, to get me to come aboard. Well, guess what? Pay a little more to come aboard. So I mean, I got a $15,000 pay raise at a lunch and went to NASA.
So now you went and helped set up stuff in Antarctica.
Yes, I've been to the North Pole twice. I've been it's your job, you know? I mean, it's right, not like, right. Ooh, look what I've done. I mean, that's what I did.
And here's I know all this because you and I have had many conversations. It's been a while since we've got to talk.
Yeah.
But, again, because I want to recopy this, since you're going to make this a video.
Right, right.
It's going to make it easier for me because I don't have this. I don't have the tech to do everything I need to be able to do.
Yeah.
But I would like to share for my viewers that are searching of at least your – it's not about bragging. It's about what you've done and what you've experienced. Yeah, so I know who you are a little bit.
Yeah, I hope no one takes this as I'm bragging.
Credentials, you know? Yeah, like you say, credentials.
Yeah.
So it's not about – right. It's just the fact that a lot of people have questions about this. It's like you can say, hey, I've been there, I've done this, I've done that, I got a t-shirt to prove it. You know, my last thing was the Ocoee River. I just did, you know, so I've still got the shirt on.
I saw you there. It was cool, man. It was beautiful. So here's the thing, is that's why I try to get people to understand, is that I have a unique view that how many people have actually been to the North Pole and actually gone to Antarctica and actually put their hands on spacecraft and... Not a whole lot. Not in our world.
So here brings my big question now. This is the one that everybody's going to go, oh! You don't believe in the globular Earth's concept or the heliocentric model.
Yes.
Helios,
right? The false god is another word for Satan. It's all the same. I believe I wanted to be an astronaut when I was 12, just like every other little boy, right?
Right.
And I believed in the heliocentric solar system, the planets going around an elliptical orbit around the sun, and the 24 degree, you know, tilt of the axis spinning at over 1,000 miles an hour crap. And I believed all of that and that we would absolutely go into outer space. But when I got saved a long time ago, all of us in Christianity, we do this thing where we try to squeeze in between the lines of scripture that tell us the truth, the knowledge of God, the knowledge that comes from revelation, knowledge of God. We try to squeeze in what man tells us in between the words and make it work. And I'm telling you, it doesn't. It's completely disconnected. They're not connected in any way. One is what man says, one is what God says. Which one are we going to believe? And I have... You know, I guess I'm dogmatic about that. I, like so many Christians, I've heard pastors and cheered along with them. The heavens reveal the glory of God, and they talk about galaxies and how huge a star is and other galaxies and other solar systems, not solar, but other systems, star systems, planetary systems out there in the vast universe. And they say how that glorifies God, except for it doesn't. Because it's knowledge that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. And so
let me ask you another question. I know there's some stuff that we share with each other that we wouldn't really put out to the public. I mean, seriously, there's a lot of stuff that really the public couldn't handle. I mean, and that's just a fact of reality. That's the truth.
Yes.
And, you know, there's things that I know that I have information on that I've shelved that I would never put out publicly because I want to stay alive for a little while longer.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm ex-military. I've done some things. I've seen some things. And, hey, we keep our mouths shut about certain things. That's cool. But I do want to also ask this question. You too, like many of the population of the Earth, have also experienced what people are referring to the quantum effect or the Mandela effect. You've seen these changes physically with your, I mean, you're a part of that group that people say they've been affected, but I personally think the ones that are experiencing these effects have not been affected actually, are the ones that it didn't. We see what the changes are, but we're not actually.
Well, I think that we're not the affected. They are the affected.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's
we're the ones
the
that
ones
have come
that
through it.
See.
We're looking at it going, y'all are missing something here.
right.
Well, you know.
What was the first change for you that you noticed?
Well, let me give something to qualify it, to lead up to it.
Okay.
You know Gon Chimera, you know, Face Like the Sun? Terrific.
Right.
YouTube.
Awesome.
L.A. Marzulli and all these cats. Listen, these guys, L.A. doesn't really delve into CERN that much, but Gon certainly had. And for years, and you have too, we knew something was going to happen. We knew that they were messing with the veil. That is a scriptural word, but a dimensional barrier between us in this realm and something that's in another realm.
One of my old videos from 2011,
yeah,
I did a chalkboard thing, and I talked about the scalar technology, mm-hmm, and the weaponry,
yeah,
and I mentioned CERN right in the middle of it all, and yeah, I talked about the chemtrails. That was back in 2011.
Oh, that, yeah, video you were, still well. Yeah. Well, you were a real weirdo, right? I mean, you
I've
were,
always been.
Yeah. Yes, well, and so... So we all knew, and I listened to these guys, I listened to you, and this was...